if you look at the sky after sunset and you see something very bright glowing near the horizon and you say, oh my God, what's that? It's almost certain to be Venus. It's one of the brightest objects in the sky. We call it the evening star or the morning star because it's close to the sun in the solar system, it tends to follow the sun or precede it in sunrise. So the symbol for Venus is actually a hand mirror, because Venus was the Roman goddess of love and of beauty. And we see this symbol all over the place, not just in astronomy, because it's culturally, it's now our symbol for woman or for femininity. And this is counterbalanced by the symbol for Mars, which people recognize as a symbol for men. It's a circle with an arrow coming out of it. And that's the representing the shield and the spear, because Mars was the Roman god of war. And so these are these symbols that have come out of astronomy into everyday life, meaning male and female. Well, it's often called our sister planet because it's right next door to Earth. It's the next planet closest to the Sun. And it's also almost the same size as Earth, which is interesting. And it has an atmosphere like Earth does as well. But it's not a place that you would want to go on holiday, not at all, because that atmosphere is actually almost entirely carbon dioxide. And so what we see on Venus is actually a runaway greenhouse effect. So that atmosphere is very, very good at trapping the heat from the sun and keeping it there. So Venus is incredibly hot. On the surface of Venus, the temperatures are high enough to melt lead. And with that is incredible atmospheric pressure. So standing on the surface of Venus, you would feel the same amount of pressure as if you were 800 meters below the surface of the sea. Above that, if that's not enough to put off your holiday plans, the atmosphere rains sulfuric acid. So basically, it's not a very hospitable place to be. Even though it's one of the closer planets to us, it's very unlikely that we're probably going to send human beings there in the near or even in the far future.
Now, in an unexplored region of space, Mariner was placed on its Mercury intercept course by the gravity of Venus.
Yeah, so it's hard for us to see the surface of Venus, or it's impossible for us, because it has this really, really thick atmosphere. So we, being humanity, mostly the Americans and the former Soviet Union, have sent a number of probes to Venus, all the way back from the 60s through the 70s. Some of those orbited and used radar to pierce the clouds, and some of them even managed to land. And now this was a very difficult piece of engineering to accomplish because the conditions there are so harsh. And in fact, the earlier landers didn't make it very far. They were crushed by the incredible pressures or melted by the temperatures. But some of them did actually make it down there. So we do actually have pictures of the surface of Venus.
NASA's Mariner spacecraft, after traveling 4 months and 217 million miles, began fulfilling its mission as it rendezvoused with the planet Venus.
This year, being 2009, is of course the 400th anniversary of Galileo taking a telescope and pointing it at the heavens. And one of the things that he observed, which was very, very important, was he managed to observe the full phases of Venus. So Venus, like the moon, undergoes phases from our point of view, because it changes its position relative to the sun. And at Galileo's time, he was still working under this idea of the universe, that the Earth was at the center. And his observations of Venus undergoing this full spectrum of phases didn't fit in with that picture at all. And in fact, that was one of the greatest pieces of evidence that they had, that system was wrong, and that we had to move our understanding of the universe away from the Earth being the center towards the Sun being the center. So for me, that observation of Venus, it just goes to show what astronomy does. Astronomy makes us change the way we see ourselves as part of the larger universe. And simply by taking a telescope and pointing it at the heavens and seeing something new that didn't fit, we had to change our entire worldview.